Before the Clone Wars even kicked off, Hailfire droids were used across the galaxy by the Muuns of the Intergalactic Banking Clan's Collections and Security Division to punish customers who failed to pay their debts on time. Because of this, some of the clones bred on Kamino were specifically trained and conditioned to memorize every single function and operation of these droids so that they could take them down with ease. So who were these elite clone troopers? Let's find out. Before we get into it, make sure you're subscribed for more awesome Star Wars lore content. Because the clone army were being absolutely torn to shreds by Hailfire droids early in the war, and whole platoons of clone troopers were being eliminated at once, the Jedi Council very quickly mobilized their specially trained Hailfire clone troopers and readied them for battle. These troopers were organized into the Bantha Squad and included a variety of clone trooper variants, including heavy weapons specialists, aerial recon troopers, and demolitions experts. With these combined skills, the Bantha Squad was capable of pinpointing and attacking Hailfire droids with incredible accuracy and the firepower needed to shred them to pieces without warning. Each member of this elite unit was outfitted with modified Phase 1 clone trooper armor, and many of them chose to trim their armor with light and dark green designs, and they were very proud to show off their squad affiliation. They wanted all of the other clones to know that they were the Bantha Squad, the best of the best when it came to Hailfire droids. Most of the Phase 1 armor worn by the Bantha Squad was reinforced to protect against heavy blast detonations from the Hailfire droids, and the commander of the squad even wore extra plating on his helmet and body armor, along with a karma. This armor saved his life on multiple occasions and definitely prevented crippling injury. So while you're in the comments below, let's keep the tradition going and give this brave trooper a name. In addition to this, the aerial troopers of the squad were given high-power macro binoculars that attached to their helmets, and they also carried highly covert and secretive communications equipment in order to relay critical tactical information and sensitive data. As for weapons, most of the Bantha squad was issued with standard DC-15A blaster rifles, and the aerial recon troopers of the squad were given the lighter and more compact DC-15S blaster carbine. Awesomely, the aerial troopers also had their jetpacks outfitted with built-in warheads, which were specifically targeted at the Hailfire droids and could cause devastating damage to enemy units when detonated. Being a typical clone commander, the commander of the squad chose to attach a pair of customized DC-17 hand blasters, mostly just for show, to his belt, although I'm sure he got some pretty good use out of them over the course of his duties. Combined, these armaments, as well as the specialized knowledge that was ingrained into the heads of these elite soldiers, allowed them to take down Hailfire droids with ease, and they would often be sent in ahead of large deployments to clear the way and make a landing operation far, far safer. So, those were the clone troopers who specialized in obliterating Hailfire droids. Thanks so much for watching, really hope you enjoyed the video. Cheers guys, hope to see you in the next one.